So the question here is that weight or that down pressure that it's exerting on the ground enough to set off one of these mines?
My prediction is that the hovercraft is gonna make it just fine. Even though it weighs, fully loaded with a person, over 600 pounds, I don't see it exerting 300 pounds down on its underskirt. It's just, it's not gonna happen.
We're about to find out, with Janie in the hot seat and a high-tech minefield rigged and ready to blow, can a hovercraft really float through an anti-vehicle minefield?
Oh yeah, here it comes. Oh yeah! Yeah! It didn't set off a thing. That was awesome!
Yeah!
That was smooth, explosion-free sailing.
Oh yeah!
The S-curve layout ensured Janie crossed a majority of the mines, but not a single one went boom.
Yeah! You want to come back around for a second run?
On my way.
Maybe a little slower this time.
Despite reducing speed, giving the mines more time to register the passing hovercraft, the Heinemann gets away unharmed.
Not a thing. That was beautiful. Yeah!
Well, there you have it. We drove across the minefield with the vehicle, and we're setting off the mines. The hovercraft, not so much.
I was right! I like being right, every now and then.
Look, it may seem counterintuitive to you that a 600-pound hovercraft can't set off a mine engineered to go off at 300 pounds, but this myth is all about the exact kind of pressure. A human foot, a car tire, those are point sources of pressure. But the hovercraft is distributing its weight across its entire footprint, across the entire cushion of air that it's riding on. That's why it can't set off our mines. That's why it is the perfect craft for making its way across a minefield.